The human personality which most influenced Eric was no simple cartoon character.
I always felt this about Walt. He would never allow anybody to pull him down to their level. In other words, TV and a lot of the things that are coming out now are dragging us down from our tradition to this. And I should, maybe, I feel it, so why don't I say it? But look, Walt, when he decided to go into color in his shorts, he wanted color. It was better. It was a higher standard than black and white. And the guys in the business moaned and groaned, "You're going to break us." Walt says, "Okay, if it breaks you, all right." But he says, "This is what we're going to do. We're going to get that much nicer thing." Now, when he started the parks, why couldn't he just have gone out and done a roller coaster and places where people would play dart games and throw rings? He comes up with, built on the cartoon characters, he comes up with Disneyland. He would never allow himself to be pulled down to a base. He was always up here someplace, trying to pull people up to him. I know that's a heck of a challenge, but he had the talent to do it.
Walt also created an environment at his studio that Eric never forgot.
I found when I got here that you hid nothing. All these people, talented as they were and at the top of the profession at that time, were so anxious to have you know everything that they knew, and they would talk to you about it. You could ask them questions. They would sit down on the board with you and diagram what they were trying to tell you. I felt that this exchange of ideas was the whole thing the studio was being built on.
Today, Eric builds on that foundation. As head of Disney's animation training program, he guides young artists through pencil-drawn animation tests like this one.
First of all, this whole business is really pantomime business. And caricature is a very strong point. Caricature doesn't always have to be real broad and wide. It can be underplayed as well as overplayed, you know. So whatever character you're going to use or do, be sure you analyze it first and find out exactly what that character is capable of doing.
I'm going to do a ballet dancer. And the reason is why, as Eric mentioned earlier, is because I know that. Well, I dance and I can visualize it. And we need to do something that you can imagine in your mind, see it already before it's on paper. And that is something that I'm very familiar with. Dancers are basically very often shy. They have trouble speaking in public or on stage. They use their body, that is their voice. They spend most of the time in front of a mirror and they're constantly watching themselves. And so I'll be trying to get across how vain yet shy dancers are.
Well, I'm going to do a dog, so putting on his pants. So the first, I think I'd be better if I had a pair of pants, but you get the pants. He's going to turn around, pick up some pants. I think the first leg will go through fine, no problem. Puts the next one down. I think that'll work. Puts this foot in. If it doesn't catch, the body will come forward, and that puts him into a hopping sort of a thing. And you'll see him react to it somehow. He'll be confused or mad or whatever.
Did you get a
feel? To help young animators better understand body language, right. Eric often uses a mime. The mime performs in silhouette to highlight the body's outline.
Well, fear, like everything else, I guess, has to stem. You feel it right from your foot, the bottom of your feet up into the top of your head. But then we would probably try to put emphasis on that. We would try to get a feeling of a quiver, a quality of shake that would be in there that would suggest an additional visual feeling of fear. The cruelty comes out, I think. Of course, there's several different kinds. I think the cruelty that the fox and the bear exhibited when they danced around the tar baby, making fun of him, enjoying teasing the little guy. He was helpless. I think that's one kind of cruelty. Another body action would simply be the approach of a character to the victim, the feeling of being bent over and ready to annihilate him the moment he could get his hands on him. Hands are, of course, so very expressive and so very difficult to draw. It's the final statement of what the pose is. The hand, even if I were to admonish someone about something, and I would come forward to say, don't you ever do that again. But if I use my hand and I say, don't you ever do that again, my expression on my face would convey one thing, but this again is a physical thing and you'd better look out.
The police are everywhere. I want the job done tonight.
And where do you think you are going?
To tell the boys we sailed with the tide, sir.
You will go ashore, pick up Tinkerbell, and bring her to me.
If it's pleading, they're extended and out in front of you.
Brother Fox, whatever you do, please, Brother Fox, please don't bring me in that brown bag.
If we're mad, that hand is usually clenched, and it's giving out a warning.
Sentence first, verdict afterwards.
But that just isn't the way.
Always on
your ways, Your Majesty.
Well, in love, most of our characters, like Cinderella, I think we've had to use the whole body and another character to indicate it. It's been a very physical, visual thing with the tenderness of the prince as he kisses the girl.
So this is love.
Oh my goodness.
What's the matter?
It's midnight.
Eric Larson has spent a lifetime bringing life to drawings. For these young artists, he's the key that unlocks the secrets to 50 years of Disney animation.
Eric was the person that I first met when I applied for a job here. And Eric, to me, is just the answer to everything. And he can help you with your drawing, or he can help you with why you can't work that day. You have artist block. Eric, I can't draw. I haven't been able to draw for a week. And somehow he has a way of working you out of it. Basically, whenever I need help with anything, I come here.
He always reminds me of just the fundamental things that I tend to forget. You know, it's like animation's so complex, and everyone, how many drawings are in there and stuff, but Eric always comes back to, like, what does the audience perceive?
The fact that he stayed here all these, he doesn't need to be here, but it's his love for what the medium can be, and, you know, and what he sees in us as people, and what he can give us that keeps him around.
Working with the younger animators has been a great lift. It's part of the studio, and to see a new staff developed, and they are developing fast. We've got some wonderful young people coming along. This has to be a source of satisfaction, and there's something about young people that helps to keep you young. It helps to keep me young, even though I don't look it. But the spirit is there.